We are on the top of Holtedahlfonna Glacier, so around 1,160 meters above sea level. This is the highest glacier in the Spitsbergen, so western part of Svalbard. So I'm holding an ice core. So what this is layers of snow that have fallen over time and been compressed and have become ice. And this we drilled from the glacier that we're standing on. And behind me is the drilling dome. So it's 6 meters wide, 4 meters high. And at the top, we see that half circle. That's the winch that allows us to drill into the ice and pull the pieces up. And that's where we spend most of our day.
So this is the drill system with the winch and everything. And this is the head of the drill. So here you have three cutters. And basically it rotates, and every time it rotates, it just eats a little bit of ice slowly, and then it goes down. So at the maximum, in one pass, we take a meter length ice core. So that one is longer, but on top you have a lot of electronics and anti-torque system. So it's a very high technology machine, in fact. It doesn't look like, but it's a very precise, and it's a lot of decades that people are building this kind of system and always try to improve them and make it super, super nice. And there is also very precise depth measurement, because we want to know exactly at a minimum a centimeter what depth we are and what depth we take the ice core. This is extremely crucial for the science. It's in the good right direction.
Why do you have gloves on?
Well, to not contaminate it, because even in the lab, when the ice will be back, we usually cut a little bit around. But even when we manipulate the ice, we don't want to contaminate it. So as soon as it's taken, it will be put in plastic bags, sealed, labeled properly. And then we put it in these small white boxes here, label with snow into it, and then directly in the freezer. And basically, we never open the box anymore until they come back into the lab. That's the plan. And you can see that this is glacier ice because you have air bubble into it. So that is a really nice piece of glacier ice.
The ice core that we are going to collect, we will do several analyses, including trace element analysis, so the impurity and the chemistry within. We will study the black carbon with the colleagues from the Norwegian Polar Institute and the University of Perugia. There will be also the microbiology that will be studied for the first time in an ice core from Svalbard. So we are doing a lot of analysis on this core to extract as much information as we can.
And why is it important to do all of those things on the same ice core?
It's very important because we can compare our result, and the result made by one group can support the result from the other groups. So working together, we will have a much more strong and important reason than try to work alone.
So I'm interested in looking at life, specifically microorganisms. So bacteria, fungi, viruses, things we can't see with the human eye and we need a microscope to see. And I'm interested in studying how these organisms evolve in relation to changes in the environment, in the planet, in the climate. So seeing that these organisms that are at the very base of our tree of life are responding to the climate tells us also something about how our planet is responding to climate change. So we can use it for prediction, but we can also use it to develop and determine new kinds of molecules and also look at evolution.
Holtedahlfonna, det interessant vi har, det fortsatt en stor bre, som ikke ennå så mye påvirket på grunn av klimaendringen, på grunn av det ganske høyde, så det får ganske enda nok snø, og ikke så mye smelting, men om 50 år, det blir kanskje for sant. Så den ideen at vi kommer hit, og så det er den ideen av det Ice Memory Project, er at vi må ta iskjene før det er for sant.
So this is our kitchen tent. This is our living room tent. We have some benches so we can all sit together. It would be difficult to do this without a tent and a stove like this, because especially the past few days have been challenging weather-wise, so. Okay, so now the walk to the tent. It's not so far. So this is my tent. And it's kind of a classic tent. I think almost everyone in Norway has one like this. And you come in, and this is it. So we have these cots, some of us, which are really nice. Other people prefer just to sleep straight on the snow. I have the jervenduk, a big sleeping bag. And yeah, it's nice and cozy.
Yeah, make sure that it's flat. It's gonna to take us probably 3 hours. It's a little bit bumpy. And then we have to drive carefully. And of course, because we want also an ice core, we don't want ice cubes. Otherwise, it's not fun to analyze. And then we lose basically a lot of information.
In the freezer container, there is the ice core that has come down from the Holtedahlfonna. This ice will be storing here for the next couple of months, and suddenly one core will be sent in Antarctica later on to the Dome Sea. Will be shipped to Dome Sea, where there is the ice memory sanctuary, and most likely two core will be used for scientists and analysis.
What would you say about the quality of the ice here?
But to me, the quality it's one of the best that I've seen. So I did several campaigns. I mean, it's pretty nice. I mean, this is very valuable for do analysis. So that's the quality is super nice.